courts in Central Florida at that time would make him do. And, you know, without going into a lot of detail, I would just say this, that at that point in time, I think you'll understand what I'm saying by saying the church could have done a better job helping in that particular situation. One of the big things is a child misses when they don't have a dad around is the dad is somehow supposed to paint, and the men of the church, the dad and the men of the church are supposed to paint the picture of the characteristics of God the Father, because a child needs to see that authority, discipline, love, care, provision, and all those things that the Father provides for us, though we are imperfect. They see glimpses of that, and then our hope is one day they trust in Christ as their Savior, they're regenerated, born again, and then they know because of what they have seen, and then what they know in Scripture, that they can go boldly before the throne of their Heavenly Father, because they know they are welcome to be there, and He desires for them to come to Him. That's how children are supposed to grow up. But I dare say I'm right that in many cases in this room, along with my wife, you did not receive that kind of treatment. You got the opposite representation of the Father, and that's what happened to my wife. But the book is wonderful. It's a whole redemptive thing. She's doing great now. She had a hard time with the relationship with her Heavenly Father back then, but God's done a wonderful work. And the whole key to it is in Hebrews that she realized, you know what, when you've seen the Son, you have seen the Father. And He had been there the entire time, and He always will be there. And she has a wonderful relationship with her Heavenly Father now. So the book is just a beautiful picture of how that all happened in her life. But in the book, there's a little piece, what I'm getting to, there's a little piece of, so I told her when she wrote it, I said, honey, this book is about you. You don't feel like you have to go on and on and on and on about me. And she didn't. She didn't. She was kind of kidding, but okay. So in the book, she told about when she was a little girl, she used to avoid the distraction, if you will, from the rejection, the anxiety and the pain of that she was suffering, you know, the depression, literally, because Dad didn't want anything. She used to watch this television show called The Monkees. Y'all remember? You weren't watching Billy Graham Crusade your whole life. I know you saw it. So she used to love to watch The Monkees. Her favorite character was a guy by the name of Davy Jones. Did you notice all the ladies just said Davy? Everybody, Vicky loved Davy Jones. She thought he was the nicest guy because he always rescued the girl. He was always really nice to them. And she just loved his singing and all that. And she used to think as a little girl, I sure hope one day God lets me marry somebody that's like Davy Jones. That's right, folks. You are looking at Vicky's monkey right here, right here. Taller and a lot less cash. Her favorite song that he used to sing had a line in it, and it said this, that you once thought of me as a white knight on his steed. And that's how she viewed Davy, as a guy that would come along and rescue the girl, and maybe one day she would be rescued. So recently I recorded a solo album, and John Darren Rousey, the guy who sings with The Guardians, he was the producer of that album, amazing talent. He produced that album. And I told John, I said, I want to do something special for my wife. I said, she wrote about this song in her book. I said, I know it's not a gospel song, I said, but it's really good. And I think it'd be a nice gift to Vicky to do this. So I recorded the song, and I'm going to sing it for you. And I got a feeling you guys, some of you maybe, might even remember. Oh, I could hide 'neath the wings seat. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but six rings and I rise to wipe the sleep out of my eyes. My shaving razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up. Without another one to spin, but how much baby do we really
sing with me. Here we go. One, two, three.